Can radars detect life on Mars? Everyone has a dream. Some of us dream of Mars. Here are three things that we know about the red planet. Number one, at a distance of 54.6 million kilometers from Earth, Mars is the fourth planet from the Sun. Number two, it is smaller than Earth. Number three, at this time, Mars's surface cannot support life as we know it. Also, here are three things that we don't know yet. Number one, when are we going exactly? Number two, if we are staying. Number three, if Mars ever supported life as we know it. Making science, we can try to find an answer to these unanswered questions. Now we just have to explore the deepest secrets of Mars. Literally. Join me to find out how the use of radars could help us detect life on this romantic planet. As humans, we have always strived to find proof of life on other planets. Scientists are now taking a chance on Mars. On Earth, all forms of life need water to survive. It is likely, though, not certain, that if life ever evolved on Mars, it did so in the presence of a supply of water. On Mars, we will therefore search for evidence of life in areas where liquid water was once stable, and below the surface where it might still exist today. On the NASA website, we can read, "Because water is the key to life as we know it, earlier Mars missions were designed to make discoveries under the previous Mars Exploration Program science theme of Follow the Water. The launch of the Curiosity mission rover marked transition between the themes of Follow the Water and Seek Signs of Life. In addition to landing in a place where past evidence of water, Curiosity was seeking evidence of organics, the chemical building blocks of life. Places with water and the chemistry needed for life potentially provide habitable conditions. Future Mars missions, as the Perseverance rover of NASA's Mars 2020 mission, will search for life itself in places that continually evolve from discoveries by prior missions. New and previously developed technologies will enable us to explore Mars in ways we never have before, resulting in higher resolution images, longer ranging surface mobility, and even the return of Martian soil and rock samples for studies in laboratories on Earth, as the case of NASA's Mars 2020 mission. But let's get deeper into what we discovered a few days ago. We know that on Mars's surface, the lack of a substantial atmosphere makes liquid water impossible. But 2 years ago, in 2018, a group of Italian scientists announced evidence of salt water beneath the southern polar caps of Mars, salty lakes at the Mars South Pole. On September 28, 2020, they had confirmation of that. Subglacial lakes on Mars. That is water at liquid state. A team of researchers led by Sebastian Emanuel Loro and Elena Petinelli, University of Rome, has confirmed the presence of a saltwater lake system under the subsurface of Mars at the South Pole. First thing first, how was it possible to make such a huge discovery? Well, scientists used radars. This is actually a really common technique. For instance, we use radars to identify subsurface glacial lakes on Earth in regions like Antarctica or Greenland. But how do radars work? A radar device emits radio waves, running at the speed of light, that bounce off layers of material in the planet's surface and subsurface. And the way the signal is reflected back indicates the kind of material that is present at a particular location. If electromagnetic waves traveling through one material meet another material, the waves will reflect or scatter from the boundary between the materials. This means that a solid object in air or in a vacuum will usually scatter radar radio waves from its surface. Radar waves scatter in a variety of ways, depending on the wavelength of the radio wave and the shape of the target. When the signal comes back, it bounces off in a way similar to the way light is reflected by a mirror. They also brought a new approach, adapting radar techniques used by satellites orbiting Earth to image buried geological features. Their analysis looks not just at how bright an area is, but other metrics as well, such as how the signal strength varies, indicating how smooth the reflecting surface is. A high reflectivity area indicates bodies of liquid water trapped under the ice. The Marsis, Mars Advanced Radar for Subsurface Ionosphere Sounding Radar, one of the instruments on board the ESA Mars Express, is an Italian instrument developed by the University of Rome La Sapienza and Thales Alenia Space. It revealed in 2018 a high reflectivity area with a diameter of about 20 kilometers. This could have been possibly explained, admitting the presence of a subglacial lake under the Mars ice. On September 28, 2020, scientists confirmed that discovery, lake's position, and extension and intensity of the signal were confirmed. But they found out there are other three new high reflectivity areas. This was a mind-blowing discovery. The main lake is surrounded by three other smaller than the first liquid bodies, but we cannot say if they are interconnected due to the radar technical limitations and its distance from the Martian surface, says scientist Elena Pettinelli. But the heat coming from the interior of Mars alone would not be enough to melt the ice into water. Scientists say that for the water to be liquid, lakes on Mars should be salty. From a thermal point of view, it has to be salty, says Pettinelli. In fact, salt melts ice and helps keep water from refreezing by lowering the freezing point of water. This phenomenon is called freezing point depression. That's why if you live in a cold place, in winter you might see trucks spreading a thin layer of salt on roadways. This causes snow and ice to melt on impact rather than freeze, and makes the roads wet rather than icy and dangerous. The freezing point depression, as the world say, is the decrease of the freezing point of a solvent on the addition of a non-volatile solute, for example, salt and water. In all cases, the substance present in smaller amounts is considered to be the solute, while the one present in larger quantity is called the solvent. The chemical potential of the solvent in the mixture is lower than that of the pure solvent, so that the resulting liquid solution has a lower freezing point than the pure solvent. That is, to have ice, you have to lower the temperature above 0 degrees Celsius. By the way, scientist Roberto Orosei, principal investigator of Marsis experiment, comments, "The discovery of an entire lake system implies that their formation process has to be simply and common, and that these lakes would probably existed for most of the planet's history. That's why they could still keep traces of some forms of life that lived on Mars a long time ago, when its atmosphere was similar to the one existing on primordial Earth. But how salty can a lake be to support life? Before finding out the answer to this question, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve and make these videos better for you, the viewer. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel, clicking the bell so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Lakes with a salt content that is about 5 times that of seawater can support life, but as the concentration approaches 20 times that of seawater, life is no longer present," said John Priskiw, an environmental scientist at Montana State University in Bozeman. "In fact, in Antarctica, there's not much active life in these briny pools, so maybe they're just pickled, and that might be the case on Mars. So as we can see, it's an open debate, because in order to have water in a liquid state, lakes have to be salty, due to the low heating from the interior of the planet. But in order to support life, they must not be too salty. Extreme environments, including hypersaline lakes, are so harsh that only a few organisms can survive in them. Called extremophiles, these organisms are found in the most challenging environments, the hottest, saltiest, and most contaminated places on Earth. Extremophilic organisms are capable of growth and reproduction at a low sub-zero temperature," said Harvard's Avi Loeb, one of the study's authors, in a press release. "They are found in places that are permanently cold on Earth, such as the polar regions and the deep sea, and might also exist on the Moon or Mars. Salt-loving extremophiles, called halophiles, in particular are interesting because the Martian soil is full of salts, briny remnants of now evaporated surface water. Life on Mars would also share with halophiles the challenge of high UV levels, as the atmosphere of Mars offers little protection from this damaging radiation. Which are the future perspectives? The authors of the discovery recommend to intensify the exploration in Mars' polar regions in order to find some other subglacial lakes and in order to determine their compositions and their astrobiological potential. Also note that some of the big VIPs like Elon Musk want to go deeper and deeper to find out every little secret that Mars might have hidden under its red, dusty atmosphere. He said that he's planning to bring humans to Mars as soon as possible. We are developing new technologies to reach these important goals. We expect humans to prepare for human exploration on the red planet and maybe settle colonies at some point. As always, everything will be made possible, starting with small steps. For instance, we can't wait to see in action the Artemis mission that will open up a new window on space missions to Mars. We will send, hopefully by 2024, humans to the moon again. And then it will be appropriate to say, to the infinite and beyond. The beauty of humankind is that we are all dreamers, and our dreams are big, and they become bigger and bigger every time we understand something new about the universe we are living in. We are romantic people living in a romantic life in a romantic universe, asking ourselves, where do we come from? Why are we here? Why are we alone? And we believe that our approach to this infinite romantic unknown is what keeps us alive. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, everyone. Did you find this discovery to be exciting? Are you amazed by the unknown that we are facing every day? What do you know about previous missions and studies on Mars? Is there anything more you want to hear about life on other planets? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.